Ugnayan at 20. As part of its welfare program, the Armed Forces of the Philippines established the AFP School for Enlisted Men, or AFPSEM, in military camps nationwide to provide secondary education to soldiers who wish to obtain a high school diploma. The schools are non-sectarian, operating under the Department of National Defense. They were granted recognition by the Department of Education on September 2, 1946. The AFPSEM 1st Military Area in Camp Olivas, San Fernando City, Pampanga, opened its classes in 1952. However, when the camp was made General Headquarters of the Philippine Constabulary in 1959, AFPSEM IMA was moved to Camp James Ord in San Miguel, Tarlac, Tarlac. Classes were held in two sessions. The night session was reserved for soldiers and day sessions were for military dependents. To maximize the classes, the school opened its gates to residents of neighboring barrios and was thereafter renamed Armed Forces of the Philippines Non-Military School, or AFNOMS. On June 16, 1962, Republic Act No. 3494 was enacted by the Philippine Congress, changing the name of Camp James Ord to Camp General Servillano Aquino. And in 1966, the school was renamed Camp Aquino High School, pursuant to a directive that all AFP schools would be renamed after the respective camps in which they were located. When AFP raised the educational qualifications for enlistment in the regular force to high school graduates, Camp Aquino High School continued operating to accommodate military dependents and civilian residents from neighboring barangays. Night classes accorded working students and late schoolers the opportunity to finish high school. Since the mandate of providing education to citizens is with the Department of Education, Culture and Sports, the school was turned over to the provincial government in 1973 by virtue of a resolution signed by Governor Eleodoro Castro. The school was renamed Tarlac High School Annex, becoming a satellite of Tarlac High School Main in San Vicente, the oldest public secondary school in the Philippines. Eventually, when public schools were nationalized in 1984, the school became Tarlac National High School Annex under the national government. With the implementation of the K-12 Basic Education Program, it now offers junior and senior high school levels. Over the decades, the school has produced thousands of alumni. A number of them notably excelled in various professions such as education, medicine, business and commerce, engineering and architecture, laws, arts and culture, mass media, military and preschool, among others. The first alumni association, named AFPSEM Alumni Association, was organized in 1985. The initial grand alumni homecoming was held in Camp Aquino, which comprised of whole-day activities and capped by an evening affair at the Biwa of Tarlac. The first alumni association, named AFPSEM Alumni Association, was organized in 1985. The initial grand alumni homecoming was held in Camp Aquino, which comprised of whole-day activities and capped by an evening affair at the Biwa ng Tarlac. The second grand alumni homecoming was held on May 24, 1986 at Santa Rica Compound, Blossomville, Tarlac, celebrate camaraderie and kinship. In 1990, the grand alumni homecoming was held for 2 days, April 14 to 15, at the TNHS Annex compound with the theme, Reminiscing the Past. However, with the busy lives of the alumni, the association became dormant for almost 12 years until Batch 69 spearheaded the Grand Alumni Homecoming with activities linking the past, the present, to the future. Thereafter, a series of meetings were held with Batch 69 Lead Group, Manila Core Group, and some active members of other batches. It was unanimously decided to revive and revitalize the Alumni Association and have it registered as a foundation to assume a juridical entity and be entitled to receive grants and donations not only from alumni but from other benevolent donors to carry out its altruistic mission. The core group's utmost desire and concerted efforts realized the registration of the alumni body in July 29, 2002. It was registered as AFPSEM-CAHS-THS-ANNEX-TNHS-ANNEX Alumni Foundation Incorporated with the Securities and Exchange Commission under CRN 20025249. As a non-stock, non-profit association, its main objective and purposes are to deliver a program of services to its members and people of the community, enhance brotherhood, camaraderie, leadership, friendship, among others, as stated in the Articles of Incorporation of the Foundation. Its original board of incorporators were Cirilu de la Cruz, Lucia Tañedo, Tarsila Pacursa, Noraida Dante, Julieta Rivera, Venancio Bitanga, and Julieta Santillan. For the purpose of brevity, the alumni coined the term Ugnayan to refer to both their association and foundation. Ugnayan's logo features four wrist-gripping hands representing the four names of the school, signifying unity, faithfulness, and allegiance to the objectives of the alumni body. Its yellow background symbolizes the energy coming from the sun, indicative of the power that sustains the body's strength and unity. The circle means continuity of interaction, cooperation, and camaraderie among its present and incoming generations of alumni. The stars stand for excellence and achievements of its alumni in colors yellow and maroon, which were the colors of the four schools. Since then, the Grand Alumni Homecoming has been held annually. On May 3, 2003, Batch 70 hosted the event themed Kapit Bisig para sa Kapayapaan. Morning activities were conducted at TNHS Annex Campus and the evening was held at the Central Park Hotel. It featured a major milestone for Ugnayan with the groundbreaking ceremony of the Bahay Alumni from funds collected from initial alumni benefactors. Batch 71 did not relent on the challenge of hosting the May 2004 event at the school campus for day activities and at the Las Haciendas Luisita for the evening event. They also organized the Alay Lakad 2004. On May 7, 2005, it was Batch 72's turn to host the annual homecoming and made more fun with raffling of gifts for the attendees. On December 15, 2007, a Christmas alumni homecoming was hosted by Batch 73 at the TNHS Annex Campus. After 3 years, Batch 76 initiated the May 1st, 2010 Grand Alumni Homecoming with the theme, Nobody's Left Behind. It was succeeded by a well-attended event on April 30, 2011, with Batch 79 hosting Ugnayan Tayo Forever, featuring Teacher Salute Award and Brigada Escuela. The same activities were held on May 5, 2012, during the Alumni Homecoming, hosted by Batch 80. That same year, Ugnayan officers and directors felt the need to review the Foundation's constitution and bylaws, as the provisions were based on the SEC prototype. After the September 2012 election, the new set of officers and the board submitted their final review and amendments of the CBL, which were ratified on September 12, 2013. To link the organization with the school it represents, the body adopted TNHS Annex General Alumni Association as the official name of the organization. On May 4, 2013, Batch 81 hosted the annual homecoming themed Balik Tanaw. The activities comprise of medical and dental missions, legal assistance, trade fair, tree planting, Brigada Escuela, and Salute Awards. That same year witnessed the completion of the Bahay Alumni after 11 years, fulfilling Ugnayan's dream of building an edifice that would serve as the alumni's home within their second home, where they could conduct business in direct coordination with the school. Batch 82 proved its unity by hosting the May 3, 2014 Grand Alumni Homecoming with the theme Together as One, that included a tree planting, Brigada Escuela, and Salute Awards. On May 2, 2015, Batch 82 relished their turn in hosting the event themed Hold On, Reach Out, Be Counted. It had a Salute Awards, recognition of Golden Jubilarians and Silver Jubilarians, Brigada Escuela, and outreach activities at the DSWD Home for the Girls and Amor Village. On April 30, 2016, it was Batch 75 that hosted the homecoming at the school campus during the day and at the Aquino Center in the evening with the sentimental theme, Paano Kita Malilimutan? Paano Kita Mapapasalamatan. In 2017, the Grand Alumni Homecoming was hosted by Batch 72, revolving on the concept, Then and Now. Hayun kami noon, heto kami ngayon, kami nagbabalik tanaw. That same year, the organization was jolted by a huge challenge when the elected leaders that time registered a separate organization with the Securities and Exchange Commission Tarlac Extension Office bearing the name Tarlac National High School San Miguel General Alumni Association. Hence, the general membership reverted to the old name Ugnayan to distinguish itself from the breakaway group. In 2018, the 17th Ugnayan Grand Alumni Homecoming, focusing on holistic approach to life, body, mind, and spirit, was jointly hosted by Batches 60 and 62. On May 4, 2019, Ugnayan held its 18th Grand Alumni Homecoming at St. Michael's Park with Batch 73 at the helm, with the theme, Sama-sama, Kita-kita, Basta Masaya. The activities included a motorcade, breakfast, mass, and parlor games. The COVID-19 pandemic caused a temporary hiatus on Ugnayan's activities. But in March 2022, the alumni world was struck by a huge blow. Their beloved alma mater was renamed in 2020 at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, without them and even the community knowing. Worst, the name change did not undergo the process prescribed by Republic Act 7160 or the local government code. No consultation was made with all the stakeholders that were definitely affected by the name change, such as the students, teachers, parents, non-teaching staff, and the community as a whole. They were not represented in the City Council's deliberation of the city ordinance as the local school board was not convened. Thus, the alumni decried the name change for being arbitrary, lacking in transparency and consultation, and contrary to law. Since then, the Ugnayan alumni had been clamoring for the rectification of the process, committing to undertake the necessary, proper, and legal process in choosing a new name befitting their beloved school that would reflect its glorious history, unique identity, and proud legacy. Ugnayan alumni expressed their staunch opposition to the name change in a myriad of legal, peaceful, and creative ways. They led a series of dialogue with school authorities, held a silent protest, posted opposition tarpaulins in the community, engaged in the city government, attended public hearings, and made representation to the Department of Education, Region 3, House of Representatives, National Historical Commission of the Philippines, and DepEd Central Office. On September 4, 2022, hundreds of alumni braved the pandemic and flocked to the St. Michael's Park for a get-together dubbed Kitag Kits. They committed to consolidate their forces and converge efforts to pursue their opposition to the renaming. The day also unfolded another milestone in Ugnayan's history, with the updating of the foundation's SEC registration. As Ugnayan celebrates the 20th year of its foundation, its members vow to faithfully and conscientiously live up to the lofty standards of their alma mater, to serve and defend the principles for which it was established, and maintain and uphold absolute loyalty to her noble ideals. For the past 20 years, some of Ugnayan's remarkable accomplishments include the completion of two-story Bahay Alumni and the conduct of outreach programs, career guidance, lectures and seminars for senior students, student cash assistance, national greening, and Brigada Escuela, among others, for the school. It has also organized batch get-togethers and reunions, recognition of alumni as school graduation guest speakers. It has sustained the Alumni Salute Awards and batch hosting of annual Grand Alumni Homecoming, with each host batch leaving projects for the school and the community. More than ever, Ugnayan is dedicated to deliver a program of services to its members and people. enhanced brotherhood, camaraderie, leadership, and friendship in service to God, to our country, and the community. Yan ang AFPSEM-CAHS-THS, ANNEX-TNHS, ANNEX Alumni Foundation, ang ating ugnayan, makasaysayan, makahulugan, at maaasahan.